Bill Maher stated faith means making a virtue out of not thinking. It's nothing to brag about, and those who preach faith and enable and elevate it are intellectual slaveholders keeping mankind in bondage to fantasy and nonsense that has spawned and justified so much lunacy and destruction.
In America, if you say the word faith, which is what Hobby Lobby basically said, this is our faith, everything stops. Everybody just throws logic out the window and puts that at the head of the class. And nobody ever really says what I keep trying to say, which is faith, it just means that's my opinion. That's your opinion. Your faith is an opinion. I think it's a particularly stupid opinion. I've never understand why faith is good. People say the word faith and everybody just backs off. Just tell me why the purposeful suspension of critical thinking, which is faith, why that's a good thing. Why is this a good thing when you go, you know what? I'm not even going to apply logic to this situation. How about that?
Right.
Wherever we go beyond reason into faith, there's no such thing as compelling evidence. Even if you have a revelation, you have a revelation. How can you transfer that revelation to others? By what system?
Without the afterlife, morality couldn't survive. Now, what's your response to that idea?
God is blackmailer. God is a warden of the prison. He created us all in his image, probably a mistake, and then allows us to run wild and punishes us or rewards us with his beaming vision of himself. This is no God I really want to have any traffic with at all.
A horrible idea that there is somebody who owns us, who makes us, who supervises us, waking and sleeping, who knows our thoughts, who can convict us of thought crime, who can do thought crime just for what we think, who can judge us while we sleep for things that might occur to us in our dreams, who can create us sick, as apparently we are, and then order us on pain of eternal torture to be well again. To demand this, to wish this to be true, is to wish to live as an abject slave.
My religion says this is right, this is wrong, it's as clear as that, it's black and white, I don't have to think about this anymore. It's just a matter of faith. Ooh. And this, and we honor that. We say, oh, it's a matter of faith. I think we have to stop honoring people for stopping thinking.
What the Bible was for your father, Darwin's Origin of Species, was for you?
Yes, except that it was absolutely based on generations of quiet science, quiet people really thinking. There's no bullshit involved at all, no wishful thinking, no absurd myth-making, no ridiculous covering up of deep fear. All of the Bible, all religions are composed of cowardice pretending to be reality, abject cowardice. We don't like to think that we are undoubtedly going to die.
1,000 years, people have been, our species has been around on this speck. Born, usually dying, actually a great number of them in childbirth wouldn't have got beyond being born. For the first 80 or so, 90 or so thousand years, nearly 100, not living more than 25 to 30 years at the most, then probably dying of their teeth, if they were lucky. Terrible disease, suffering, misery, malnutrition, and fear. Where do the earthquakes come from? Why is there an eclipse? What are the shooting stars doing? And awful cults of sacrifice to try and ward off what are in fact natural events. And war, and rape, and the kidnap of other peoples, and the enslavement of them. All of this goes on. For the first 97, 98,000 of this, heaven watches with indifference. Oh, there they go again. They've all, this, that whole civilization's just died out. Well, what are you going to do? They're raping each other again. They're poisoning they think that the other tribe has poisoned the well, so they're going to kill all their children. All this, just watch all that. 3,000 years ago at the most, it's decided, no, we've got to intervene now.